Hello! And this lesson, in case you saw the little picture for this video, is going to be English for work. Yeah, English for work. Oh, I'm covering up my head. Yeah, English for work. So let me just make sure that I have you so I can see your comments as I'm giving this lesson. We'll pull that over there. That's my cat, Charlie. I think he's very excited to see everybody today. And yeah, so I want you to, do a lot of people work out there? Do you have a job or are you a student? Do you like your job? Do you like school? That's the question. And there are different ways that you can describe people from work. And I'm just going to show you the first picture here. This is a little bit shocking for some of you. And but I mean, it happens at work. So here you can see in the first picture here, you have to add light on you. Oh, well, I'll do that next time. Not much I can do right now. Maybe turn on a light. Yeah, I could do that. Yeah. Leda, do you think you could turn on this light here? They're saying that it's kind of dark. Oh, thank you so much. Yeah. Anyway, so what do you think? Oh, engineering student. In this picture here, you can see that this is an expression that we use. And this one, if you get the idea, is called brown noser. A brown noser. And a brown noser, this comes all the way from school. We use this in school, like when a student is very nice to the teacher because they want something. So I remember I had this one student, I think his name was Ali, and every morning when I used to come into class, he'd say, "Steve, what happened?" I'm like, "What do you mean? You look so good. You look so nice today. What happened?" And I'm like, "Ali, what do you want?" That kind of student is called a brown noser. And a brown noser, let's see if I can find, make sure that it goes to the right. Yeah, that's going to be the right one. Yeah. A brown noser is somebody who is always paying compliments to someone in authority, like the teacher, like the boss. And you could say, "Oh, that guy is such a brown noser." Yeah. You can also use it as a verb. You could say that you are brown nosing your teacher, or you're brown nosing the boss. Yeah. So that's what a brown noser is. So I don't know if you know somebody at work who's a total brown noser, or maybe you remember someone from school, or maybe you are in school and that person is a total brown noser. You could also say apple polisher. Maybe you know that one. Yeah. And that's what a brown noser is. Yeah. So let me know. You let me know down below if you know anybody who is a brown noser. Yeah. So that's the first one there. And I guess we'll make these a little smaller. Yeah, because I can see on screen that it's cutting out the text just a little bit. So we'll make those a tiny bit smaller, a teeny tiny bit smaller. Yeah. Yeah. And Ahmed has a good way of saying it. It's somebody who flatters or pays compliments to someone who is in a position of authority. "Oh, you look so good today, sir. Oh, you look, that's a really nice dress you're wearing, Mrs. Smith." Yeah, that's a brown noser. So that's the first one. And the next one that we have here for an expression that we describe someone at work is this picture here. Let me make it bigger. Kind of the same idea. By the way, one of the comments from somebody who's watching this lesson is that he has some brown nosers at his work, at his job. So brown nosers do exist. Yes. We know they exist. Yeah, it's one way of getting ahead. Yeah. Yeah, Muhammad, it's a good thing, Muhammad, your comment. I'm not going to show your comment, man. Yeah, that one there, yeah, I understand that comment, but okay. Julia says, my little girl is a brown noser to me about her elder sister. Could it be? Can you brown nose your... She's always brown nosing her elder sister. Yeah, I think that sounds about right. If your sister is, like, in a position of authority over your younger daughter, I guess that would work. Yeah. If she's babysitting her or something like that. Anyway, there's this one here, and this is similar situation. And this is a good expression. And this is kissing up to the boss. And kissing up to the boss means something similar to brown nosing. So kissing up to the boss, you're always paying the boss compliments. You always do what the boss wants you to do. Yeah. So that's kissing up to the boss. Yeah. Somebody has asked a good question here. Suck up to the boss. Very similar to suck up to the boss and kiss up to the boss. So if you're sucking up to someone, to kiss up to the boss means you're paying him compliments. He's always sucking up to the boss. Yeah. Yeah. I think those are interchangeable. So good one. That's a good one. High five. Yeah. Did you Google that or did you know that? That was good, to suck up to the boss. Yeah. And that's a really good one to know. And it's not vulgar. It's not street talk. Kissing up to the boss is a very politically correct way of saying it, because you could say it in another way, which is, oh, we lost the picture here, which is this one here. So imagine this is your boss. So this is the street talk way of saying it. Yeah. Have you ever been brown nosed? If so, tell us. Okay, well, let's go back to that. So I'll save that question, Mohammed, for the end of the class. Mohammed was asking me if I have ever been brown nosed, and certainly I have as a teacher. I can tell you many stories, and I'll try to tell you one little story at the end of our lesson. This one, yeah. This one, I think you can imagine. This is street talk, and the vulgar way of saying this, the street talk way of saying this, is to kiss ass. Kiss ass. Yeah. And you can use it as a verb. He's always kissing ass. Or you can use it as a noun. He is such a kiss ass. Yeah. He's always saying nice things to the boss. You know, he wants something. Maybe he wants to be promoted or something like that. Oh, he's such a kiss ass. What a kiss ass. That's kiss ass. Yeah. And yeah, kissing ass. You could also say, yes, that's right. You could say kissing ass. No, we would not say kiss the ass. We don't use the article there. We would just say kiss ass. Even though ass is countable. Yeah. Asses. In this case, we say kiss ass. So you can use it as a verb and you can use it as a noun. So my question for you is, are there people at your work or in your class that like to kiss ass? Yeah. Are there some kiss asses in your class or at your job? Yeah. So that's kiss ass. Yeah. And you don't want to use that in front of other people all the time. That's a street talk way of saying things. Kissing up to someone is a lot more politically correct. So that's that one there. And then we have this one here. And this is someone at work who... this is someone at work who is always agreeing with what the boss says. So the boss says, what do you think of this plan? Oh, great idea. Yeah. Could you get me some coffee? Sure. Yeah. Could you go and pick up my dog from the kennel? Yeah. He is the dog. He's a lap dog. And we have an expression for that. And this is particularly called a yes man. And a yes man is exactly that. He's the guy who always says yes to the boss's requests. Or when the boss asks his opinion about something. He always says yes,
yes,
yes, yes, yes. Oh! Yeah. So that's a yes man. He's a yes man. So I hope you understand that one, because that's an important one to know about somebody at work. Could you say yes woman? I don't know. Probably they would use yes man in a generic way. Yeah. You know, she's the boss's yes man or something like that. Yeah. They would use it like that. So there's that one there. And we also have another thing to describe. Oh, someone said, this is me. Yeah, Julia, an obedient man. Yes, exactly. Yes, good.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah. But that's a good description of it, an obedient man. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we'll go to the next one here. Do the transition to the next one. And we'll see if you can get this one. I should find a picture. I think that would be better to give you guys a better idea of what this looks like. So just give me 1 second here. Just 1 second. See if you can guess what this thing is. Yeah. So as you can see in this picture here, this is what we call, I've got to get my live dashboard back so I can see what you guys are saying. This is a brownie. This is a chocolate brownie. You can see that? This is a chocolate brownie. So we have an expression for brownies. We say that let me just show you here. See, this comes from school. And you can see that we have those same little pictures on a piece of paper of a brownie. Can you see that? Let me see if you can see that. You can't see that because my picture's in the way. So give me just 3 seconds here, so if I can make it easier. Maybe make it smaller. Yeah, there we go. Let's just wait and see if I can pull it over here. Yeah. So those are called brownie points. And someone in school, when they do something right, when the teacher says, oh, good job, yeah, they will give them 1 point. And that's called a brownie point. So you get 1 brownie point, 2 brownie points if you do your homework every day, 3 brownie points if you come to class on time. So that comes from school, when you get brownie points. And they use that for work too. So you can earn brownie points as, meow, can you hear my cat? Meow! My cat, that cat, she's losing brownie points. But yeah, you can earn brownie points with someone, and that means that you earn points with someone, that you get on their good side, if you know what I mean. And that's what to earn brownie points means. So, yeah. So it's when you do something, yeah, like somebody said here, Muhammad, I think if you get them if you do something good. If, as they say in informal English, if you do good. So that's right, Muhammad. Yeah, that's exactly right. Yeah. So, yeah, exactly, Katakali. The teacher will have a good impression of the student. So when somebody has in authority a good impression of you, you do something right, ching, you get a brownie point. Yes, you come to work on time, ching, get a brownie point. And believe it or not, there are a lot of companies that use brownie points, or you get a star if you complete your work on time. They will give you these little points and they'll put them on a board and say, good job, good job, good job, good job. Yeah. And apparently a lot of employees like it. Yeah. It's just like being in school. Yeah. So at school you get a brownie point, and at work you get a brownie point too. Yeah. Yes, that is a Canadian cat. Anyway, so that's brownie point, and we say you earn brownie points, and you get those at work. And let me see if I can find another expression related to work. Can't use that one. So this cat here is not getting brownie points because she kept me up all night long meowing. Yeah. Oh, she's got an attitude problem. Say something. Want to say something? No brownie points for you, cat. Okay. Yeah. She's not getting any brownie points. Yeah. Yeah. We've got some other cats that have brownie points, but not that one. Okay. Anyway, so that's brownie points. Now, and someone said, give me the cat, she's so cute. Oh, wonderful. Yeah. I think businesses... Okay, and then Juan Pablo, you have an interesting idea. I think businesses do it, the brownie points, because they don't have to pay extra money to their employees. That is exactly right, Juan Pablo. So it's a way to encourage or give incentive to employees without having to pay them extra money. Yeah. Julia says she's not a yes cat. That is so true, Julia. Anyway, so that's that one there. And we have this one. I'd like this picture here. And see if you can see it on full screen here. Yeah, that cat's always angry. We'll wait for it to change screens here. Yeah, now you can see. What do you think is happening in this picture here? Yeah, we'll pull that up a little bit more. What do you think the idiom for this is? This is something that we use at work all the time. Not even at work, but like anywhere. Yeah. Yeah, that's very good. Angela got it. Yeah, woohoo! Yeah, so that's exactly what we say. The walls have ears. Now, for everybody who is watching this lesson, maybe you can help out by explaining what the walls have ears means. When the walls have... Oh, eavesdropping. Very good, Katakali. Eavesdropping. And when we say the walls have ears, it means that other people can be listening to what you're saying and you don't even know it. You don't know. You just, you know, you're talking and you think that nobody's listening, but there could be someone just around the corner and they're listening to what you're saying. So be careful. Be careful what you say at work, at school, because the walls have ears. Yeah. And now the walls have Facebook. Now the walls have Snapchat. So be careful. Yeah. You could be on Facebook Live and you don't even know it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, Mohammed, you have a good definition here of the walls have ears. You have to be careful about your words. You have to be careful about what you say because you don't know who's listening to you. Yeah. Yeah, it is kind of like Big Brother. Yeah. So this is going on YouTube, so I don't know how much I can say about that. As Steve drinks some water. Yeah. The walls have ears. Yeah, not much I can say about that. Yes, quite. Anyway, so that's the walls have ears. And let's see if we can find another one. Amen. That's a good way of saying it. Be quiet in case we may be heard by someone. Excellent. The walls have ears. So that's really good. You guys have a good idea. I don't know if it's the same expression in your language. You can leave me your comments if the walls have ears is the same in your language. I was giving this lesson to some of my private students and they said that, yeah, it's the same in their language. Yes. Anyway, we have a few more. This one is also used to describe the business world. And I want to see if you can guess what this is. I showed you a cat in my video. Now we've got dogs. What's happening? Cats, dogs. So, what do you think is happening in this one here with the cats and dogs? I'll give you a hint, and that's that the world can be very cruel, and the world can be very cruel. It can be very competitive, especially in the business world. So we have an expression for that, and I'm curious to see. I could type it out. I could tell you right now. I know cat fight almost, but these are dogs. So be careful. Dog fight, you're getting warmer. Yeah. Fight of dogs, maybe. Yeah. So when those dogs fight, when we say that it's a very cruel world, it's a very competitive world, we can say that it's a dog eat dog world. Let me make that a little smaller so that you can see it full screen. Business rivals, kind of Kathakali, yeah. So I don't know if you've heard this expression before, a dog-eat-dog world. Have you heard this before? A dog-eat-dog world. Dog-eat-dog world, yes. That yes dog suddenly turned into something else. I don't know if you've heard this expression, but yeah, Cold War. I don't know if you've heard this expression, dog. No, you haven't heard this expression before. So a dog-eat-dog world is exactly that. It means that not everybody is nice out there in the world. Some people, they will sell their mother for a promotion at their job kind of thing. So it's a dog-eat-dog world. Yeah. So I'll write that out. Dog-eat-dog world. Yeah, and in case you hadn't heard that expression before, great. Then you have learned a new expression, a dog-eat-dog world. Yes, okay. Dog-eat-dog. Do you think it's a dog-eat-dog world out there? Yeah, or do you think it's kind of like, what a wonderful world. I see trees of green, red roses too. Or is it more like a dog-eat-dog world? You let me know. Yeah. Okay, so nobody's heard it before. Yeah, so it's a dog-eat-dog world out there. Yeah. But there are similar expressions in other languages. I know that, taking the cat hair out of my mouth. Yeah. Cat hair, dog-eat-dog world. My students told me that they have similar expressions like a dog's world, I think in Portuguese, mundo cão. In French, my French student told me that you would say it's something like a wolf. Yes, a young wolf in the world. Yes. So you want me to write the definition of a dog? Yeah, I will do that. Yeah. And if you're just watching a recording of this video, it's a very cruel and competitive world. Yeah, so a dog-eat-dog world, a cruel and competitive world. Yes, some people will do anything to get ahead in life. And that's my last idiom for today, which is to get ahead. And let me show you that one there. Yeah, that's to get ahead. So to get ahead means to advance and to maybe be in front of the other people that you're competing with, to get ahead. Yeah. So in a dog-eat-dog world, some people work very hard to get ahead. They work very hard and they use all of their talent, all of their energy to get ahead. And some people, they're a brown noser, they're a yes man, they uh, pardon my language, but they kiss ass. Yeah. So, I mean, there's two ways to get ahead in life. Yeah. You can do it by working hard, or you can do it in other ways. Mm-hmm. Yeah. To be outstanding, to get ahead. Yeah, exactly. So that's to get ahead. And that's the last one. Let's see how we're doing for time here, because I think we can go for about, okay, so 30 minutes. I think that's a good time. Okay, so somebody, Muhammad, I think Muhammad had asked me a question earlier on. And I'm sorry I can't answer all your questions. It's just so many of them are coming up at the same time that, you know, if I would need to do another YouTube session where we just have like a question answer period. That would be really fun. Yeah. So we could do that maybe in the next the beginning of our next lesson. Maybe tomorrow on Facebook Live. Yeah. But somebody had asked me if I had ever had a brown noser or a somebody that used to kiss up to me when I was a teacher. Of course I did. Of course I did. Yeah. I mean, when you're a teacher, you always have people that are going to kiss up to you. And I think the best story that I have with a student that was kissing up to me was I had a mother and her son. They were studying English in the same class with me. This was many years ago. And at Christmas time, she gave me a keychain. And I don't know if you know what a keychain is. Maybe I can find a picture here, because my keys are not here. They're hanging up somewhere. So for Christmas, she gave me a keychain. Let me see if I can find a picture. Yeah, she gave me a little keychain as a Christmas gift. And okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yeah, that's very nice. The mother gave me a keychain. At the end of the semester, the mother passed the final English test, and her son failed. He failed. His English was terrible. He just didn't have the right level to pass. And his test was terrible. He got like, you know, like 3 out of 10 or something like that. And when his mother saw the result of that test, she came running into the room and she said, "But I gave you a keychain at Christmas." I'm like, so that's, and I was like, well, what's the connection? Yeah, didn't make sense for me. Yeah. So that's the story there. So that's an example of a student of mine, the mother who was kissing up to me. Now, some of my friends told me, well, you shouldn't have asked for the keychain. You should have asked for a car. Yeah. But that's not my style. Yeah. Nobody can kiss up to me. Yeah. I'm not for sale. Yeah. Think about that. Yeah, you can think about that. So, anyway. Okay. So, I hope you enjoyed the lesson, everybody. We had a lot of idioms today. You can always watch the video again. And I know I apologize that I can't answer all your questions today. But hopefully we can, as I said, have a question and answer session maybe tomorrow. So we will be on Facebook Live. That will be tomorrow, Saturday, at 8 p.m. Europe, 2 p.m. New York City. Yeah, yeah. And I hope you enjoyed the lesson. It was great seeing you guys, and it was a really good lesson. Yeah, yeah. I hope you learned a lot. And we will put you on big camera so I can say goodbye. Goodbye, everybody. Yeah. And thanks to the student who told me to put some more light on. That's my wife came and turned some more light on. So we'll leave with some music. Well, I can't find my music player. Do I have to sing it? Do 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 do. Bye, everybody. Yeah, have a great Friday night. We'll see you later. Thanks for coming out.